Hello everyone, welcome back. So student, now we are going to sum up our chapter with this topic. As this is will be the last topic of our chapter. The topic is relationship between total product and marginal product and marginal product with average product. So let's start. As this can be asked in your examination also, that what are the relationship between total product and marginal product, average product and marginal product. So for that you have to first make an illustration like a table in which unit of land, unit of labor and marginal product will be assumed by you. Okay, according to this information you have to calculate total product and average product. So here I had assumed unit of land is a fixed factor, so I had assumed it one only, at the fixed factor will remain constant, you all know. Unit of labor is variable factor, so it may changes. So I had decided to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 till 8 variable factor. Now I had assumed marginal product is 6, 14, 28, 24, 8, 4, 0, minus 4. Before assuming marginal product, you have to think first thing, that first will be the dash. From second one, as I had made, first will be the dash. From the second one, you have to increase the marginal product at a some point. Afterward, you have to decline the MP. For example, 6, 14, 28. Till 28, I had increased marginal product. Afterwards, I had declined it. From 28 to 24, 8, 4. There will be one position where MP will be 0. I had made on 7, MP will be 0. And at last, MP should be negative. Okay. So, these things should be kept in mind while assumption of marginal product. Now, you have to calculate total product. You all know the formula of total product. First will be the dash. Then from MP we have to calculate total product. So from the down to upwards we have to add. First will be 6, 14 plus 6, 20, 28 plus 48, like this only. And for average product you all know that the formula will be total product upon labor. Okay. So as you know, 6 upon 1 will be 6, 20 upon 2 will be 10, 48 upon 3 will be 60, like this only. Okay. So after making this table, you have to put these items, this transaction, this data into a graph. First of all, you have to make total product graph, and second of all, you have to make average product with marginal product graph. So as you know that total product is there, on first total product is 6, I had make a point on 6, then on 20, then 48, then 72 and so on. So this will be the position of total product. Afterward, you have to make marginal product and average product on the same basis. Now let's talk about the observation or the relationship between total product and marginal product. So first, marginal product is increasing, TP is increasing with increasing rate, which means when the marginal product is increasing, TP will increase with increasing rate. So here we can see in an example that when marginal product is increasing, 6, 14, 28, till 28 it is increasing. Total product will also increase at an increasing rate, 6, 20, 48. MP start diminishing, TP start with diminishing rate. Means when MP is going to decline, MP jab kam hona shuru hoga, at that point total product will increase but with a diminishing rate. You can see from 28, 24, 8, 4. Now MP is going to decline. Here total product is increasing but a diminishing rate. For 72, then 80, then 84. As you can assume that, or you can see that at during the condition when marginal product is declining, TP is increasing but with a decreasing rate. Now the third will be the MP equal to 0. This is the condition, MP is equal to 0 is also known as TP will be maximum at this point. So here you can assume that this will be the position where total product is maximum. Okay, now MP equal to 0, here MP is 0 on 7th position, you can see TP is maximum on 84. Okay, when MP is negative, TP start declining. Means when marginal product is negative, TP will start declining from 84 to 80. So this will be the observation of total product and marginal product. Now let us take a relationship between average product and marginal product. Average product increase as long marginal product is greater than AP. Means when the marginal product is greater than AP, then only AP will increase. AP decrease when marginal product is less than AP. When marginal product will be less than AP, AP is going to start declining. So in the first position you can see 6, 10, 16, 18. Till here marginal product is 6, 14, 28, 24. Means marginal product is greater than AP. That's why AP is increasing. After 18, 16, 14, 12, 10. Here marginal product is 8, 4, 0, minus 4. Here the marginal product is less than AP. That's why average product is declining. Next, AP is maximum when AP equal to MP. यानी कि AP will be the in the maximum position when MP is equal to AP. So when you will make this graph, at a some point the two curves line will interact each other. Here it will be the position when the two lines will interact each other or cross each other. At that point only MP is equal to AP. So this point will be the point where AP will be maximum. MP may be negative or zero, but AP continue to be positive. It means MP can be zero or negative, but AP will always be in positive. Plus में रहेगा AP. AP will never go on zero or negative. Okay, class. If there is any query related to this topic, please ask. After this video, please do the questions which I had given to you for this chapter. Thank you very much.